5-8 and Glenn Iller at fullback. And of course, Ken Wright is at inside centre. Let's look at the Randwick team. It's as selected. No changes at all there. Everybody at full strength. And of course, Gary Pearce, number 6, the breakaway, and Ken Wright were two of the stars of the Australian team in that great win over the All Blacks in New Zealand a couple of weeks ago. Eastern Suburbs too are also as selected. A solid combination, and their international player back with them today, he was in fact back last week, is the fullback Jeff Richards. Now here we await the presentation or the arrival of the first grade teams. It's good afternoon to Trevor Allen.
Well, thank you, Norman, and good afternoon viewers once again. As Norman has said, the ground is in pretty good condition, fairly dark in the centre, but it is not muddy or slippery or anything. It's quite powdery, I would say, more of powdery grass and soil, so it's very good for the players, holding well, and the ground generally is showing that there's plenty of pace out there. And with Randwick, the side must be starting hot favourites for this first grade grand final. They are a side that really like to run the ball, and they have a great deal of pace in their backs. And Eastern Suburbs are a side that like to keep it fairly tight because they haven't got the pace in the backs. But all in all, the conditions are good for both sides. As Norman said, no sun to worry about here today. And the wind conditions at the moment hasn't affected anyone to any degree in the lower grades, probably varying a little bit from right to left, but not any major problem.
There was some extra time earlier on today. Trevor has the minor grade scores. The fourth grade, the third grade, in fact, was won by Eastern Suburbs 12-9. Now, in fourth grade, the two teams, Manly and Northern Suburbs, played extra time after it was 9-all, and they're declared joint premiers. Now, this is the interesting point we must make straight away in the event of drawn games. It's happened in rugby league in Sydney for the last 2 years. It happened in the VFL in Melbourne last year. Now, the rules are different between rugby league and rugby union. In this game, if the scores are level at full time, there will be extra time, 10 minutes of extra time. But in the event of the scores being level after extra time, the two clubs are declared joint premiers.
Members of both teams, ladies and gentlemen, I'd just like to...
here's the Randwick mascot, the Galloping Greens, as they are referred to, and most of their football is played at a galloping pace. And here's not the quickest in the world, but a couple of Galloping Greens.
And, of course, the Galloping Greens followed out by the team itself, and Randwick coming straight out. Apparently, they've tossed before they come onto the field. It's right on starting time of the game. And Randwick led out by their captain, Ian Kennedy. Now, the Eastern Suburbs team coming out from the other dressing room, and here they are. They're led by Frank Curran, the veteran second rower. Both captains, in fact, coming from the second row. And some green smoke bombs have been let up over on this side of the field, and all of a sudden the ground bursts out into a pretty spectacular atmosphere.
This is a red, white and blue smoke bombs down this side, and the green, of course, of Randwick. And I can assure you that they're right in front of our camera and commentary positions, and if it comes up, we won't see much football, as you can see. He's hoping that it doesn't go on for too long.
Well, that's what we can see. Absolutely nothing over on the far side of the field. The two teams, I think, are going to line up for the presentation to His Excellency the Governor of New South Wales, Sir Radon Cutler. But this is the first time I've been to a football match where you can't see the field at all.
Ball back into touch, and let's take it out to Norman May.
Number 7 is Kite, the breakaway. A very good line out forward. And also Chapel, number 4. Randwick, to win the game, must get possession. Randwick lost a fair bit of ground there, carried it back over halfway. And the scrum.
Well, very early in the game, we can expect Eastern Suburbs to put a lot of pressure on with the forward play.
To Mark Eller on the far side. And the kick through is down to Richards. Richards to handle the ball for the first time. And in touch just outside the Eastern Suburbs quarter.
Yes, well, Richards was the Australian fullback in the two tests, or the last two tests in New Zealand. It's Richards in the background there.
Randwick back line angled back deeply with Glenn Eller poised to come in. Steen's kick is up towards halfway, and yes, he finds touch, and there are the two Eller brothers chasing after the ball. We should see a lot of them today. That's Glenn at fullback and Mark at 5'8".
Well, that was interesting to see that Randwick got that knock back in the line-out, but the Eastern Suburbs poured through, as they did last week against Gordon, and took control of the ball, and this is what they will be hoping to do all day, is to cut the play off close to the forwards.
And working the blind side to Mark Eller. Back to right, to pass on the ground. Bird, the 5'8". And a penalty, Eastern Suburbs. Penalty here. It looked to be against one of the Randwick forwards coming into that maul in a pretty wild way. And it's going to be, I should think, a shot at goal. If there's no conditions here, and Don McDougall, Eastern Suburbs goal-kicking hooker, will attempt the shot. And the halfway line is just behind him.
Well, here you get an idea of the distance. He's almost at the halfway mark. So it's quite a long kick. But, of course, he is directly in front of the cover post, mid-centre. And it's interesting to note Don McDougall, taking this kick, is a hooker for Eastern Suburbs. And we do not see hookers kicking very much. They're right in the engine room there, and it's a pretty tiring position to be. And usually you're looking for players that are fairly fresh from the backs. But he has done very well this season with the boot.
And the kick is going to fall short, I'd say. It was pretty straight. This is Glenn Eller. Not finding touch. Chance on the far side for Eastern Suburbs. Out there to the new house, the centre. Good cross kick. But Eller here. Out here to Ramsey. Long pass to Tony Walsh. Walsh quite fast. There's good push by the Randwick forwards. Bird for Eastern Suburbs. And that high one coming down onto Eller. Charging through. And is it a knock-on? Yes, a knock-on.
It's Glenn Eller. Had a great season. Youngster. Good fullback. He was under pressure there.
One side. And Steen caught by the fullback, Glenn Eller. Now Bird to Newhouse. Nice backline movement. Stapleton on this wing. That's McDougall. He should win this maul. Surprising they've lost it. Now, Randwick, here they go. Right up towards halfway. Under the fullback in front. And his pass to his winger Walsh. That's Richards making the tackle. Eller. Eller has support, but it was a forward pass. It was Mark Eller.
Well, good football by Randwick, particularly when they got that ball from the maul. Eastern Suburbs went in with the ball and had complete control of it. And as Norman said, it should be coming back, but it didn't. It came back to Randwick. So good play by Randwick forwards.
Randwick gaining possession from there. Out to Eller. Quick pass to Wright. Beautiful pass. And that was the first indication of that magnificent pair of hands that Mark Eller has. He's a real magician with the ball. And those of you watching the Eller brothers for the first time, we hope we can see in this game some of their flashes of real brilliance. Interesting technique the Eastern Suburbs half has, putting the ball in.
Yes, he just rolls it in very slowly. Again, you know, I get the impression maybe it's our camera angle. It never looks in the centre.
And Steen's kick back to this side. This is Tony Walsh getting underneath it. And Glenn Eller. Now, Riley Brown for Eastern Suburbs, number six. Out in the back line, across to Newhouse. It's Rossfield on the far wing. Now, Eastern Suburbs, Bird. And the scrum for the knock-on, about 15 metres inside the Eastern Suburbs half, right in midfield.
Very interesting to note that Bird, on the two occasions that he's held the ball or caught the ball from the 5-8 position, he's attempted to blast through on young Mark Eller and has not succeeded.
Mark Eller, a reverse to right to the far side, and right through the gap almost, yes, still going. Back in field to his forwards from McElhone. Overfield to Bright again, who's there? And Rambick put a pass down that time. Now Mark Eller, here it comes this side. Out to Tony Walsh, he might have a straight run for the corner if he can get it, but the bounce beating him. Walsh. Eller, great pick up. This is Ramsey. I think Pierce may be offside, but let's see what happens. Only about 10 metres out.
Well, that's the storming football we can expect from Randwick. They undoubtedly will set out today to run this ball wide as much as they possibly can. I'd have to make a comment. There were a couple of tackles made on some of the star backs for Randwick, and they were a little bit late.
Just notice how close Mark Eller, the 5'8", is when he's in relation to the scrum. He only stands a couple of metres away from his halfback.
Yes,
I can't recall a 5'8 standing that close.
Yes, and I think, honestly, Norman, this is the first time I've seen him standing so close. We will watch it closely. He may be just there as a link for the early moments of the game. But he normally stands wider than he is at the moment. But, of course, he's probably could be making room, make sure there's more room if his brother comes in out into the back line near the centres.
There's Ella. Clearing kick by the lock forward White is up towards halfway. That won't be in touch. It's Walsh. Walsh cross field and still going, but he's been caught in trouble now. Sing for Randwick. Nearly kicked it. I don't think he should have. There's a penalty here. Well, Gary Pearce is on the ground for Randwick, but he's okay.
I think there must have been a late tackle because this penalty is going to Randwick. And I would think there have been a few late tackles. And the referee, I didn't actually see that one, but I got the impression that the referee looked back and there was a man on the ground and he must have sighted the player that was late tackled. And so a chance here now, first chance for Randwick to see if they can land a penalty. Eastern Suburbs have had one attempt, which was a long one from just inside halfway, directly in front. This one, as you can see, it's on the 10-metre line inside the Eastern Suburbs half and about 25 metres from this touch.
And the interesting thing is that Ramsey has been preferred by the Randwick officials as goal kicker over Ken Wright. And Ken Wright was kicking goals for Australia and New Zealand.
Yes, well, Ramsey's had a pretty good season. He's kicked some good ones. And they're very confident in his kicking prowess. He's got a bit of wind to contend with this one.
Just wide of the upright. Plenty of distance there, but no score here. And we've had now upwards of 10 minutes of play. Richards drop out. It's over halfway. And Eller, I don't know why he did that. It wasn't necessary. Could have waited for that ball to bounce.
Eller is a great one. He loves to take the ball on the full. He tried that early and he made a mistake of trying to get up to it too quickly.
Now the free kick going to Randwick here. And let's see what Randwick do. They may avoid lineouts. They want to keep the ball in the play. Let's see if Wright's going to kick the touch, or apparently. Or is he? Is he going to put this up in the air?
the way he's positioning himself, I would be going for a drop kick here.
And a long drop at goal. It's going to be well short. Now Richards. And Richards, yes, finding a good touch. Very close to halfway. It wouldn't surprise today to see Randwick keep away from lineouts as much as possible.
Yes, I think they would be fairly wary of the lineouts, but they're fairly confident about their pack. It's a very mobile pack, and if it gets into trouble, they seem to be able to get themselves out of the trouble fairly quickly.
It's Pierce coming in. Well, he was on the fringe of the offside loo that time. Gary Pierce, the Australian breakaway, was probably the fastest forward on the field.
Very quick. Great player. Great player. Always after the ball. Certainly wasn't offside. And he comes very quickly. You may have noticed when Wright took that attempt at field goal just a while ago, it was Pierce. It was up 30, 40 yards up the ground.
White, number 8. Dougal, and a penalty again to Randwick. Now, this is a penalty as opposed to the free kick. They could make it.
One feels that it's just a little bit too long for him.
And the kick is short and wide. It wouldn't really have reached the distance. Now, that's Bird touching down for the dropout.
Well, this is the man that Richards, that East will be looking for, and I'm surprised that he hasn't come into the back line.
Over halfway to Glenever. Miller following this through. Stapleton for Eastern Suburbs. His kick may be too big. Yes, it is. So play going back towards the Eastern Suburbs quarter.
Stapleton, quite a good winger. That was a good catch. He was under a lot of pressure. But now the pressure must go on Eastern Suburbs. Here's the line-out coming up. Randwick to put the ball in, and their backs all set to run if they get it.
25 minutes gone in the game and still no score. Now Randwick, fullback coming in. There's Glenelow, and that's pass to Walsh, and Walsh almost to the quarter. Penalty Eastern Suburbs. Randwick unable to develop their game from that tackle.
Well, one noticeable thing too, that the number 8 for Eastern Suburbs got out very quickly, and so quickly I think he must have been standing out in the back line. I didn't notice him there when they started. Now here comes now, and here what you'll see number 8 come up. He makes an almost a head high tackle, and there he is there, and he got across fairly quickly. I don't know quite how he got there so quickly, but Easts have been covering up some good attacking play by Randwick. But in that play, Randwick brought in the fullback. Didn't use him well enough.
And in touch just over halfway. First score might be very important in this game, because Eastern Suburbs, I couldn't imagine them coming from behind to win it. They've got to really control it all the way. Now Randwick moving full back in. There's Wright, and Wright looking for the gap. He's almost a halfway, but caught by the breakaway kite. There's some vigorous racking by Randwick. Mark Eller. And a flick pass, beautiful pass. That's McElhone, the number 8. And Randwick with support here over this side to Walsh. Walsh goes for the corner. This could be a try. He's very close. Field diving and got him. Field got him. Good tackle.
Well, it was a good tackle, and that was field.
Quick throw in. Pierce over the line, on the line. But referee stopped it.
Well, that was quick. Well, it's Randwick looking to penetrate with some good backline movements, but that was a good tackle by Field. And Field was the winger on the far side. He came from the far side. Here it comes now. That was McElhone making a very good break there, looking for support. And here he found the winger with him. Now watch Field coming. He's come from the far side, and watch how close it is, only about a metre short.
So the line out just 1 metre from the Eastern Suburbs line. And on the line, that's put the ball down to try, but he can't. And that That's a clearing kick by, a very good clearing kick, in fact, by Steen, taking play almost to the quarter.
Yes, that gave Eastern Suburbs some relief. They were in a lot of trouble there. Not only the forwards, Randwick forwards, looks as though they had that ball.
Penalty Eastern Suburbs.
Oh, still no score. It's been pretty hard, but most of the time the game has been in the Eastern Suburbs half. About just on 29 minutes of play gone. They've been sending it up the back. They have buried it.
Well, the referee not satisfied with that one. That was not straight. Out to Ella. And the pass to Ramsey. There's a fullback in. Beautiful pass. Here's a great chance for Randwick. Lillis must score. He's racing away for the corner. A beautiful effort. And Lillis in for the first Randwick try. That was really good rugby.
Well, that was typical of Randwick. Good try. Fullback in. Beautiful. Couple of beautiful passes. Here it comes. Wright came in. There's Ella. The fullback came in. Took that brilliantly. And what a magnificent pass he also sent out to Lillis. And Lillis, with a tremendous pace, certainly went in with the defence just too far away. A good try.
And the shot at goal to be taken this time by Ramsey. And what do you think, Trevor, of the point I made earlier on about the first score of the game?
Well, yes, I think, Norman, when you were talking about the first score of the game, had Eastern Suburbs got it, they certainly would make it very difficult. But one gets the feeling now that the way Randwick have gone and been going in the last 5 minutes, and now that they've got a try on the board, they will just play exactly the way they played in that movement there. Let it go.
And the kick at goal is wide, so 4-0 is the score, and we've had half an hour of play.
Well, a good try by Randwick. It was a typical Randwick try. Interesting to note, you probably saw Ken Wright slip back as though he was going to take an in pass. He didn't get it. It was planned that way. And obviously that makes the defence prop a little bit, and then it was the quick passing.
Drop out right down deep to Ken Wright. And his kick is not in touch. Back it comes from Steen. That's a crossfield kick. They might run from here. That's McElhane. Here they come. Wright. And he kicked it now. I don't think he should have. It's going to bounce towards the sideline. Richards will get to it, yes. I'm just a little bit surprised with Ken Wright there. He had plenty of support.
Well, yes, I must admit, I was a little bit surprised. There were at least three Randwick players outside him. The defence wasn't quite across. I think he could have carried it further and let someone else elect to kick further downfield. Very easy up here, I must admit.
Pierce at the back. It's Maxwell, number 7, and Kennedy again. Randwick getting some ball hit, and Ella, Mark Glenn Ella, that's the hook on Maloof. Randwick want this ball. Well, they're not getting it this time. An idea of this low packing scrum.
Well, there's only 4 points the difference, 4-0 in favour of Randwick. Eastern Suburbs just can't get down into the other half.
Now, Bird. Inside Ella. It's white number eight. Now Kennedy to Ella. Ella to Ramsey. Has a chance around it. And the intercept may stop it. Field it was. Rossfield did very well. And he's up to halfway. Penalty Randwick.
And once again, the referee clearly indicating that there was a hand down in the ruck.
Injured man is the Eastern Suburbs 5'8 Bird.
I think with about 32 minutes of play, it's very noticeable that Eastern Suburbs, even in that movement there where they got the intercept and should have been flying back well upfield, well, they got it. But Randwick's pace enables them to cover up things very, very quickly.
Well, it looks like Wright's going to take a shot again from here.
Yes, it's once again a long one. I don't think there's been any easy runs today. And this one is, again, as you can see, just inside the Eastern Suburbs half. About 1 metre inside, directly in front. Fairly lengthy one, but... must be confident.
And that one is going to be short. It's a good kick, though. It's just under the bar. That was very close. It's surprising how it carried that ball, and Richards was actually standing on the goal line, under the black spot, to take it.
Yes, that's the best kick that Wright had today.
Here's the short kick this side for Stapleton. Stapleton up towards halfway. McElhane. What a pace this player. Wright. So the score remaining here at 4-0, Randwick in front, and we have about 5 minutes to half time.
Well, Randwick Hooker did well to get that one, as you could see. It was almost, as far as I'm concerned, in the Eastern Suburbs second row.
Bird. And Bird coming back in to get side of Ella. That's White. And kick not in touch. Here's Glen Ella. Glen Ella. Caught, I guess, well, in touch. Now, Eastern Suburbs had 3 players to 1 over there.
Very interesting. When Norman called it, the Bird slipped inside Ella. That's the second time he has done it. I don't think it's perturbing Ella one bit. It must be perturbing Bird because I think he's doing it, A, to beat Ella, and secondly, to link up with his forwards, but his forwards have been very slow to get out and support him. And so the movement is falling down there, and Bird's planning it.
Now, Mark Ella. Well, you count on your fingers the pass was dropped this year, and that was one of them. Now, right for Randwick. Here they go from here. They'll run out here to the Ella, to the winger. Walsh is in the clear. Only the fullback in front. Looking for infield support to Maxwell. Intercept by McDougall. There's a flash of players in McDougall and McElhane.
Well, plenty of glaring and a little bit of wind hitting the air, but... No damage done. But that was, once again, a good movement by Randwick. Back in their own quarter, they'll run it from anywhere. And here it comes. There's Wright sending it away. And what's his pass? And a little bit of a late tackle there on young Ella. And here's the winger. Lillis makes this run down the sideline there. And, of course, this pass is intercepted by the Eastern Suburbs hooker.
So play on the line out just out from the Randwick quarter. And Randwick again out to Ella. Crossfield kick. Lillis coming through on to Richards. Richards well taken. Field. Maxwell the tackler.
Randwick's pace, as you see, and I have to say it again, but they're swarming everywhere, and it's their pace that is getting them to any danger zone that Eastern Suburbs develop. And not only is it their pace getting there, they're getting there in numbers, which is making it very difficult for Eastern Suburbs.
Ella, great pass again to Wright. And a charge down, a chance here from Newhouse. He's the closest to the ball. It's on the line there over the far side. McDougall, a try. The hooker. Where did he get there?
Well, he's everywhere, that little fella, but that's a little bit against the run of play. Just when Randwick were starting to launch it, here it comes. There's the kick by Wright, which is charged down by Newhouse off his body. No problems there. And he does the right thing, gets a little kick to it. It didn't go where he expected it to go, but McDougall, the hooker, was there to score a good try.
And McDougall will attempt to convert his own try.
Well, now we must go back to the comment we made a short while ago whoever scored first would probably be able to, if it's East, tie the game up. If it was Randwick, Randwick would run riot. Well, Randwick haven't run riot since they scored their try, which is in the 30th minute. And now the clock is showing us that we have about 2.25 minutes to go before half-time. So a different complexion on the game again. And, of course, McDougall, who's scored that try, is the man that is about to see if he can convert it. So East will be very happy if he does, because it means, and I feel, that with the half-time bell almost with us, that if it goes over, Eastern Suburbs could turn at half-time in front, which is, quite frankly, or would be, if he kicks it, a shock.
Kick is hit the crossbar. Bad luck for Eastern Suburbs. Hit the crossbar. Four all.
That's extraordinary. That hit the crossbar and back and bounced back. And last week in the final, we saw three of them hit the post and come back.
Now a drop out by Wright, a long one, right down to the goal line. Richard's going to touch this down. Well, this shows the power of Wright. He's surprising how far he can kick a ball. He's not a big man. Just drop that straight over the line from halfway, 50 metres. This one to Mark Eller. Eller brothers mixing themselves up a bit. And the kick is touched by an Eastern Suburbs player, so Kennedy's onside. And that's taken it right inside the Eastern Suburbs quarter. Now, this is a pretty important minute and a half to half-time. How long? Trevor's looking at the clock right beside us here.
Now, according to the clock, it's 3/4 of a minute to go.
So, Randwick can get this. They'll be attacking for sure.
Well, if Randwick get it, it'll be an all-out attack.
It's Pierce. Call for the ball here, Maxwell. McElhane, here it comes, a great chance, must be a try, there are 3 men over. Now that's a very important try in this game, right on the half-time bell, and they had 3 men to spare.
Well, it was. There's
Ramsey,
a
by the way. Ramsey, the try scorer.
Yes, Ramsey scored the try, and it was good play by Randwick. Here, watch how the ball, we just didn't get quite back to that line-out, but that didn't matter greatly because it came from the line-out, which Randwick manoeuvred very well. And here's Ramsey, because of a couple of quick passes, finds the gap and an easy try.
And once again, the try-scorer is attempting the conversion. This time it's Ramsey.
Yes, whilst the kick's coming up, the important thing was that that line-out, it went back to Pierce, and he didn't do what he's been doing all the time, and that's knocking it back. He elected to turn and run, and this dragged all the Eastern Suburbs forwards in. And then from then on, they won the quick ball.
And the kick is there. So Randwick, a converted try in the closing seconds of the first half, and that's the position. Randwick 10, Eastern Suburbs 4 at halftime. The Randwick tries by Lillis and Ramsey. Ramsey, one for is the fullback number 15. Here's a variation by Eastern Suburbs, a short line out. Bird, Kite, the breakaway's out there in the back line. And well won by Randwick. Far side to Eller. And his grubber is up over halfway. And Richards in touch about 15 metres inside the Eastern Suburbs half. eastern suburbs. It's Bird back over the head of the forwards. Tony Walsh for Randwick is chasing this one. Underneath it is Steen, the halfback.
Yes, the penalty there, as you probably saw, for an early tackle. It's usually late, but that one was early, and the referee was watching to see if he's got the ball before he signalled the penalty, but certainly was an early tackle.
And Richard's finding touch almost exactly on the halfway line.
Well, Richards is the man that Eastern Suburbs must be looking for to add some zest to their attack. They haven't much attack, so the only way that they really can make some inroads into Randwick's area is by bringing Richards into the back line.
Now, here's Eastern Suburbs. Can they move this back line? But Bird electing to kick. Glenilla going for the deep corner. Back there is Steen. Richards now. Still about 15 metres short of halfway, about 12 in fact. That's the black 10 metre line you can see to the right. Going to be a scrum. The was ruled a knock on from the line out. Good push by Eastern Suburbs. Yellow. I think there's a very slight gap he was looking for there amongst the forwards. And a penalty, Randwick. Well, I think this is worth a shot at goal. It's almost 10 metres inside the opposing half, and bit of wind behind right. Well, you can get the distance here.
Yes, I'll be very surprised if they don't have a shot at this one. And right coming up, and you may recall his last kick, and here's the distance. He's about 9 metres inside the Eastern Suburbs half, but his last kick prior to just before half time, the long distance one, was right centre field, and almost on halfway, and it was quite a good one, just dropped under the crossbar. So this one is not as far. Secondly, he has the assistance of a slight breeze, whereas he was kicking into the breeze in the first half.
And this one's a bad kick. It's going to be well short. Richards. Now that's not in touch. Glenella going to run this, is he? Yes, he's bringing it over this side, and the up and under chasing this one. Steen's back there in defence. Call for the fair catch.
That was Glenella that followed that ball right through, forcing Steen to call for the fair catch.
In touch up to
in his own quarter. Really should put it out every time.
Well, that becomes a scrum just out from the Eastern Suburbs quarter. Again, and still Eastern Suburbs playing the game in their own half. I don't think they've been out of their own half in the second half.
Yes, they've had a lot of problems in getting out of their half in both the first half and the little bit that we've had of the second half. Randwick are able to nullify any attack that they have.
Pierce again. And a penalty, Randwick. Well, this must be a shot at goal. And see, there's going to be a change of kicker. Yes, this is a more reasonable distance, and Ramsey will take the shot and not right.
So for Ramsey, has Ramsey converted his own try. And that is the only goal that Randwick have kicked. Of course, Eastern Suburbs have yet to raise the flags from a kick. But I get the feeling, and whilst it's very early in the game, or in the second half, the clock showing exactly 10 minutes gone, one gets the feeling that East can't mount any forward power enough or big enough to take over Randwick. Fleetness of foot.
This one is a good kick, I think. No, just wide again. That was quite a good kick, and the two touch judges had a very close look at it. But no change in the score. Randwick 10, Eastern Suburbs 4. Half an hour to go. Linella. In fact, now that's Mark. And caught by Newhouse. Bird. Steen. That's back inside the quarter. That's bouncing towards the line. That's a good kick. Well, Ravik losing some ground there. They seem to be just a little bit casual that time.
Yes, they appeared a little bit casual in a few of the players. And I think it was Markella. Had a bit of a look. He was so confident and had a look before he received the ball. And I think he was looking to see where he was going. But of course, he took his eye off the ball and it went to ground. And then they were in trouble. And they are in trouble, because this is only about 4 metres from the Randwick goal line, and whilst it's Randwick's ball, it'll be difficult for them to win it.
Steen for Eastern Suburbs. Out it comes. Now let's see what they can do. Newhouse for the line with the Stapleton, and a knock on, is it? Let's see. Yes, the referee waited for no advantage there.
Well, Eastern Suburbs probably a little unlucky that Stapleton came into that back line. He did play very well in getting to the position, but had he come out wider, there were two or three Eastern Suburbs players to about two Randwick players.
There's a big push by Eastern Suburbs, and a penalty. This is right under the posts.
Yes, well, difficult to say what the penalty was for, but obviously something in the ruck there. And this is a fairly simple kick, and obviously a very vital one, because whilst Randwick are only leading by 6 points, which is a goal, a try and a conversion to be in front, if this goes over, it makes it 10-7. It's not a difficult kick, but I think one of the important things that has happened in the last 4 or 5 minutes, that Randwick appear to have relaxed a little bit, and there's no way they can do it. They must build up the tempo again if they want to maintain the lead. And if they lower the tempo, it certainly will suit Eastern Suburbs.
It's there, 10-7. About 14 minutes gone in the second half.
Dougal, the kicker, and of course the try scorer for Eastern Suburbs. Simple kick, but it counts, and that might be enough to stir Randwick up.
Kick deep inside the quarter. Richards, and in touch, 10 metres from halfway. In fact, a little bit closer than that. Once again, right to the back to Pierce. this side, Richards. Richards to halfway. Mark Ella tackling. Now the fullback's out of position here. Rossfield going back. And a penalty for the a push then by Lillis. Push tried to push Field out of the way. That was pretty obvious.
Well, that was bad luck for Randwick that they were penalised there, but there was good play by Eastern Suburbs leading it up, and that's the first time I think we've seen Richards in the play to any attacking degree. The cover from Randwick once again was too good. This is Richards kicking.
Now that's a great kick along the sideline by Richards, who's taken play up to halfway. And an injury to Mark Ella out in midfield.
Yes, I think it may have been Mark Ella that came across to get Richards, and Richards is a pretty burly fellow, and he stepped back infield, and Ella was taken, well, whilst he was taking Richards, obviously got himself in a pretty awkward position because he took the full weight of Richards' step back into him, but he looks as though he's right now. Nipping a bit there, of course.
Movement, the pull back in, and Wright's high kick. Richards on his own quarter. Call for the fair catch. And not finding touch. It's Lillis. Field.
Well, once again, not good football by Richards. Trying to get too much distance. You can't afford, when playing Randwick, to keep the ball in play too much when you kick it to them, because you give them a great chance of setting themselves up to run with it. So the best thing is to pump it out and have a line out.
Eastern Suburbs losing some ground there. It's about 5 metres inside the quarter. Now full back in again. Right, Ramsey. A drop at goal. That's a nice kick. It's there! What a kick!
Well, that was a very neat one. It was certainly a neat kick. It came out very quietly and freely. The defence was coming across, but when it got to Ramsey, he had just enough room to hook it around towards the post. It certainly was a good kick, and came exactly at the time when Randwick was searching badly for points to get them back into the rhythm again. Well, here it comes. There's the pass going out. Good passing here. That's Wright picking that one up. Here's Ramsey. Steadies himself with the defence there coming up. Plonks it, and the referee comes well up under there and could cite that it was straight between the posts.
Now, here's Wright from the kickoff. Wright up towards the quarter. Wright through three tackles. Well, lost the advantage there. That's at Eastern Suburbs now. Working the far side of Bird. At the Stapleton, intercept, away goes Walsh. There's nobody in front of him. He must score the length of the field. It's a runaway. And Tony Walsh seen a hopeless pursuit, and Tony Walsh overthrow. A Randwick try, which was totally unexpected, as Eastern Suburbs were on the attack.
Well, there it is. The fortunes of grand final football. Eastern Suburbs about to launch attack, and one of the very few that they've launched. And what happens? An intercept, and Tony Walsh, all he had to do was gather it, and gather it well, and race the length of the field. And so, most unfortunate for the... here it comes now. Watch this, Eastern Suburbs get that ball away, and here, watch, here comes the pass now, and there it is, two men to take it. Richards was coming in to take it,
but it went between the two Eastern Suburbs players, and here's Walsh flying down the field with Steen after him, but Steen only able to keep him from going around and putting it right under the post. So a good try by Randwick, an unfortunate play for East.
Well, Ramsey to attempt the conversion. Two more points, it's 19-7. And a field goal so far. That's 11 of the 19 points. Tony Walsh, by the way, was a doubtful player in today's match. He's been suffering this week from tonsillitis, and I think that try should cure plenty of ills.
Yes, sir. There was a bit of doubt about him this morning, but he certainly made up.
Now, the others moving it straight away. Here they come. Ramsey, and beautiful pass to Wright. Wright up towards halfway. Has he got support? Yes, on this side. Maxwell. Maxwell to Lillis, the winger. Lillis, great tackle. Good tackle by Stapleton. Still going in midfield. That's Glenn Ella, but it's knocked on. And Stapleton, the winger from the far side of the field, was the man who stopped that movement.
Stapleton very, very quick. And there, once again, we saw some good ball handling by Randwick. And now Randwick starting to come back with a degree of pressure football.
To Bird. Long pass to the centres. Now the fullback Richards in for the first time. There's Stapleton again. Stapleton. But look at those Randwick players there. The first two or three players there were Randwick. That's the speed they have. And a penalty Eastern Suburbs.
Oh. Obviously, a penalty going there. It looked as though a couple of players were a little careless in the way they were walking. There's Lindsay back here. I think it may be Ramsey.
Well, so in time in the second half, we've got the indicator clock just around the corner. Trevor has to get up and look round the corner to see it. And I think about 16 or 17? 20 minutes gone.
21 minutes gone. So about 19 minutes left.
So East attacking from a tap penalty. There's Newhouse out here to the centre. We haven't seen much of him. Savage. It shows how infrequently the ball's got across that Eastern Suburbs back line that I don't recall mentioning Savage's name, the outside centre, for more than about once in the game. Bird. And round it quickly to that ball. Out here to Maxwell. Maxwell to Lillis. And a penalty Eastern Suburbs.
And a penalty again for the hand down in the ruck, but very noticeable that Randwick, when they're skirting out, particularly their forwards, they get to the place so much quicker than the Eastern Suburbs forwards. And on that occasion, when the 5-8 for Eastern Suburbs Bird had the ball, it should have come out on the Eastern side, Suburbs side. It didn't, because Randwick are getting there and they're getting the numbers there far too quickly and taking control. And Eastern Suburbs forwards starting to look a pretty tired bunch, moving fairly slowly at the moment.
Once again, back for Pierce. Maxwell. Kennedy, that's a planned move. A planned move between those three, apparently. They've done that several times. Working this side, and the whistle has gone. Randwick backs all set to race again. I mean, this side, Steen. Lillis in defence. And Lillis in trouble. There's a chance for Eastern Suburbs here.
to leave the football there. They're just about ready to race at Rose Hill. 56 and at three-quarter time. Ranwick having a kick for goal. Back to Norman May.
He has now. Yes, 22 to 7.
Good kick. A nice kick by Ramsey. And there it is, 22 points to 7.
And we're just having a look at the time by this unusual method we have of looking around corners. And about 12 minutes to go. Ramrick from the kickoff. Advantage rule. It's stopped now. It's been called a knock-on. Looking to blindside goes Steen. But his kick and touch on the field.
Obviously, the game has really slipped away from Eastern Suburbs. There's no way that they can get back into this game. They just haven't the pace, either back or forward. And surprisingly, the Randwick pack really have dominated because they have quickness in getting around the field. And I must say that, as we mentioned earlier, that we thought that Eastern Suburbs may control the lineouts. Well, when Randwick have put it in, they've varied the play so much that they have been able to get plenty of control of the ball in lineouts.
Right. And taking play up towards halfway. Good jump by Kite, number 7 for Eastern Suburbs. And a penalty east. Oh, clash of players there. And on the ground is one of the Randwick front rowers. It looks like Walker.
And also one of the Eastern Suburbs players there.
That's the number 8, that's White.
A couple of rather quick punches thrown there.
Now, what do Eastern Suburbs do here? They're a long way behind. They're 13 points behind. Do you kick the penalty or do you tap and run?
Well, I think at this stage the game has virtually slipped from them. I would think if the penalty is the penalty coming up, I think they're better off just notching themselves another 3 points. And that's exactly what he's going to attempt to do. It's a long way to go. But there's always the gamble of getting a try and a goal. And they're so far behind, and there's no doubt that with only 10 minutes to go, that it's going to be a pretty forlorn hope. One could hardly see Eastern Suburbs coming back, even if this one goes over. If it would, if they did, it would be one of the greatest finishes of all time.
And the kick is good. So 22 to 10 is the score, with about 9 minutes left. And all of the points for Eastern Suburbs have been scored by the hooker Don McDougall with a try and 2 penalty goals.
Yes, he's had a busy day.
And Ramsey's kickoff is the deep one to Field. Field back to Richards. They're going to run from here apparently. Yes, they're taking it across the field. That's Bird. On the quarter. Well won by Eastern Suburbs Stapleton. Along the back line, they have a chance here. There's an overlap. But the kick through by Savage. It's in touch. Well, he had two men in support there.
Yes, I am rather surprised that he kicked ahead. He did have support. The defence was coming across, but, you know, you can let a ball go along and back up inside.
Well, Eastern Suburbs again to Bird. Long pass. Newhouse. There's a full... No, it's Stapleton who's in. Stapleton has field in support. Look at Pierce. Now that's Richards. Richards coming almost to the quarter. Back to White. Nice pass to McDougall again. On the far side, there's a pass. Goes down. That was about the best Eastern Suburbs effort in the second half.
Well, it certainly was. And that final pass, if it had been accepted, I think East would have scored in the corner. Here it comes. And watch when the finally... Here's Richards coming up, number 15. That's Stapleton setting him up into a good position. Now the race is on, and you'll see now he's crossing the quarter line. There's the ball going out, and here's the play. That's McDougall heading for the goal line, and there's the pass astray. I reckon they're only 15 metres out, and here's the play again.
Here they come again. Bird. The Quingo Stapleton's in field on this side. That's Savage. They're going well. That's Riley Brown, the breakaway, number six. Eastern Suburbs now throwing caution to the winds.
And so they should too. And that last movement of theirs was really the best movement they've turned on all day. They beat the defence and were very unlucky they didn't score in the corner.
Off the pack comes White. And the front rowers... And still going, Bird on the far side. Who's there? Now Steen to the winger, Stapleton. Stapleton back here to Richards. Richards beating tackles. They're still going. Eastern Suburbs moving it about. It's Field. And they've just got him. He wasn't far away. And still moving to Stapleton again over this side. There's a chance Stapleton might score himself. If he hadn't have gone, it could have been a try. Eastern Suburbs still moving, but a penalty, Randwick. Now, Eastern Suburbs, in my opinion, bombed a try there. Stapleton went too far.
Well, Stapleton, he was in an unfortunate position. There's no doubt about it. He went too far, but when he hit that ball, all he could see was the goalpost right in front of him. And I think, here he goes. Oh, no, that's... yes, that's...
it's Field earlier
field,
on.
I'm sorry.
Comes
yeah,
from
sorry.
Here, yes.
Stapleton comes up further. Here it comes now. Here's where Stapleton elects to go now. You'll see the goalpost. They should come up, and that's what he was looking at, and I think he thought he could go right under there. But had he let it go, there were two or three players away to his right. And so Eastern Suburbs are starting to storm home, but all too late.
No space and time. What, a little more than 5 minutes?
Six to go.
And the tap to right... And right, making sure of the sideline. Yes, that's a good one. Up towards halfway. He's really working the ball now. Bird to Newhouse. Fullback coming in, it's Field, and here's Richards in. Savage's kick. Now Randwick moving, Mark Ellap. And downfield it comes. It was McElhan who kicked that ball. The ball bouncing towards the line. He'll find touch. McElhan, the lock ball was out there in defence behind the back line. Not in straight that time, so it's a scrum. We're inside the Eastern Suburbs quarter. And a penalty, Eastern Suburbs. Now, tap and run's the only thing, I suppose, left in this situation. But... I think they realise they can't win it from here with only a few minutes remaining.
Well, just 4 minutes to go, and obviously it's going to be Randwick's grand final. Their lead is too great for Eastern Suburbs, who have really stormed home in the final moments of this game. And one wonders why they couldn't do it before, but then we must take into consideration, I do believe, that Randwick have relaxed their game a little.
Now Randwick to Markiller, right. Fullback's in, and a knockdown. Stapleton has knocked that down, but it's recalled. It will be recalled. He's knocked it on. Well, he's done it all after the bell. The whistle's gone.
Well, at least he can smile. He was all out on his own there and having a great time.
To Mark Ella, to Glenn, who's over there. Glenn with the foot, winger clear, Walsh. Over halfway, and he's found touch.
Well, can Randwick get possession and have one final fling, or will it be Eastern Suburbs? Randwick would be quite content to play it down the sideline, I think, now.
Bird to Newhouse. There's a pullback in, Richards. Kick not in touch, Glenover. Back to Mark. Across the halfback, Singh. Newhouse. Far side, that's Steen. Steen to the winger, Stapleton. Now there's no fullback in position, a chance here, back to Kite. Kite's being chased by, who's that? Ramsey made the tackle. Well, the others were out of position. The fullback was over on this side of the field to recall.
And the referee has given it a penalty further back. He's gone some 20-odd metres back. Don't know what it was for. We may pick it up in this replay, whether there was a late tackle or some hindrance there that shouldn't have occurred. And there's the late tackle. Yes, a very bad one. It was a high stiff arm with the elbow, really.
Play on. And the up and under from Karen, the captain. Right down almost the line. That's ever underneath it. And well taken by Glenella. Then an injured man.
Well, maybe McDougall, the hooker.
Time, I suppose, what, a couple of minutes to go? It's
a minute and a half to go. Clock showing a minute and a half to go.
And there's the situation. 22 points to 10, Randwick in front. Thinking back in the game, you recall that Randwick scored a try in the last seconds of the first half.
Yes, and it was a very important time for them to score, because it was 4 apiece. With the almost on half-time when Randwick scored their try to take them at half-time to a lead of 10 points to 4. So it was a very important try.
So the last minute and a half of this grand final. And kick by Walsh in touch, but gaining no ground at all. We're still only about 5 metres out from the Randwick line. The line, and is that a try? It is no try. A man was over there, but he must have been held up and not allowed to put the ball down.
Well, certainly very close, because the referee swamped in and swept in round it.
And I think it was McDougall again. The last man to get up is McDougall, the Eastern Suburbs hooker. And that's up White. He's very close. And there's a penalty. what will they do? I think they're going to tap and run. And there's the siren. So, play must finish here and see what happens. That's Karen going for the line. They're going to play the ball dead. There are children running onto the field. It's right on the sideline. And is it all over? No, a penalty again. And there's hundreds of children. This is they can't control the crowd here. There are hundreds coming onto the field. The referee has not entered the game. Eastern Suburbs cannot possibly win. And they're just trying to send those children back.
They're racing back. The kids are racing back. It looks as though we're going to go through that move again.
So here they come. And there's the charge at the line. And nobody's over yet. And it is all over. So Randwick have won the grand final by 22 points to 10. Randwick scored 3 tries, one each by Lillis, Walsh and Ramsey. Ramsey also kicked 2 conversions, a penalty goal and a field goal. For Eastern Suburbs, all tries were scored by McDougall. He scored 1 try and 2 penalty goals. Randwick, the premiers for 1978, the final score, Randwick 22, Eastern Suburbs 10. And from the Sydney Sports Ground, this is ABC Sport.